Of course, many of us know about Earache Records already. They put out some of the most classic death metal and grindcore bands out of the UK, basically in existence. Napalm Death, Carcass, Bolt Thrower, Godflesh, you name it. But what do they have to do with John Peel and his infamous Peel sessions? Well, stick around, because you're about to find out. Before I get to the vinyl issues of the Peel sessions, it might help you out to know exactly what the Peel sessions are, as well as the man behind them. For that, we're going to need a bit of a history lesson. So let's get to that. John Peel began his musical journey as a DJ in 1967 for a pirate radio station called Radio London. Given the freedoms that come with pirate radio, Peel played a lot of music from the UK underground. Back then, that consisted of a lot of blues, folk, and psychedelic rock. The station didn't last the year, and Peel went to rock journalism until the end of the 60s. At the same time, Peel started working for BBC Radio 1, initially spinning pop music, but later went back to some of the more experimental and outsider music he often gravitated towards. Peel had a bit of a rebel streak throughout his career, notably in the bands he'd helped promote. To the hatred of many, Peel spun the first Ramones album over the British airwaves and gotten a lot of hot water for it. That might seem strange in modern day, but back then, punk was a feared musical form. Of course, Peel's most notable creations were his Peel sessions, which ran from 1967 until his death in 2004. 4,000 sessions in total for over 2,000 bands and artists, many of whom not in the mainstream at the time, or even ever. Even the genres and styles were completely diverse, having recorded early versions of bands such as AC/DC, Gary Numan, Jimi Hendrix, Leibach, Pink Floyd, Def Leppard, and DOA. Given that, it shouldn't have been too much of a surprise when Peel's attention turned to the fledgling death metal and grindcore scenes in the UK. Though, it certainly was for many at the time. Truth be known, Peel was a huge supporter of Earache Records. He even had his producers seek out that label's bands to come on his show. Many of these Earache acts even credit Peel for kickstarting their careers. Napalm Death drummer Mick Harris was quoted as saying, "No Peel, no Earache." And if wondering, Earache did go through the usual legal channels to acquire the rights to these recordings from the BBC. As for more info on John Peel, check out his autobiography entitled Margrave of the Marshes, which goes into much more depth than I could possibly do in this video. As you can imagine, he was a pretty prolific guy. So let's go through the Peel sessions of four notable Earache bands, collectively known as Grind Madness at the BBC, the Earache Peel sessions. Now, there had been various releases early on for some of these Peel sessions. Some were incomplete, some were basically one session per band. Strange Fruit was a label that initially put some of these out, but these are unofficial releases from Strange Fruit, and they've been out of print for a few decades anyways. So it's nice that Earache has put them on vinyl, finally, so we get to hear them. And some of these Earache releases also have more than one session, so you should definitely be looking at this definitive collection. These were also released in 2009 on CD, but if you're a vinyl guy like I am, and clearly you're watching this channel, then you should definitely be going after the vinyl. All right, let's talk about the records. So starting things off with Napalm Death. This is three Peel sessions for Napalm Death from 1987, 1988, and 1990. So the first side has the 87, 88 stuff on it. Definitely their grindcore period. Side B is with Barney on vocals instead of Lee Dorian, and it's more death metal, as you know. And I like the death metal Napalm Death just a bit better than the other version, but still a great record. You get to hear early versions of tracks, which is really great. A particular note on the B-side of this is there's a pre-Harmony Corruption version of Suffer the Children, probably one of my favorite Napalm Death songs ever, so definitely keep an ear out for that. Vinyl color for this one is split black and white, looks like that. They call it Negative Approach, and there were 300 copies made. Also, they come with printed inner sleeves. There's this wonderful artwork. I have no idea the artist, and they kind of don't tell you. And then there's a great little collage with the band logo. In fact, this is going to be common to all three, but this changes. So, cool stuff. As we know, a lot of the early Napalm Death tracks are mere seconds long, so there are a lot of tracks on here. I'm just going to name some. The Kill, Prison Without Walls, Dead, Deceiver, Lucid Fairy Tale, In Extremis, Blind to the Truth, Negative Approach. Goes on and on. You Suffer is on here as well. Let's see if any others that stick out to me. Conform or Die, Divine Death, Worlds Apart. On the Barney side, as we'll call it, we've got Unchallenged Hate, Mentally Murdered, From Enslavement to Obliteration. So he does a take of that. Suffer the Children, of course, Retreat to Nowhere, Scum, Deceiver, and Social Sterility. So Barney does some of the early Napalm Death material that he wasn't originally on, which is kind of cool as well. Next up is a split release between the bands Carcass and Godflesh. Carcass do sessions from 1989-1990, where Godflesh's is from 1989. I love Carcass, of course. They're a great band. I think the Godflesh on here is pretty interesting. It sounds more live. It sounds a bit more raw. I love the version of Like Rats on this. I'm used to the studio version on the LP, but this one's pretty great as well. Definitely the curiosity of this record. If you get it, go straight to that track. Of course, the vinyl, classic black, and the inner sleeve is split between Carcass and Godflesh, of course. Just to go through some of the tracks here on the Carcass side, we have Crepitating Bowel Erosion / Dementia, Cadaveric Incubator of Endoparasites, and Reek of Putrefaction. Also, Empathological Necroticism, Forticide, Fermenting Innards, and Exhumed to Consume. Carcass always had great song titles. Love it. Godflesh, of course. I mentioned Like Rats already, but Tiny Tears and Wound Not Wound is on here, as well as Pulp. And finally, there's Bolt Throwers Peel Sessions. Two of these are from 1989, one's from 1990. The vinyl itself is classic black, and the inner sleeve looks like that. Great album. I love Bolt Thrower. I should say that the early material, of course, sounds a little more grindcore. I think a lot of these UK bands were experimenting with grindcore, and then later moved on to death metal, which is the more classic sound we know Bolt Thrower to have. Additionally, on the early material, it's Alan West on vocals, not Carl yet. Carl was later. The album does cover material from the first three albums, In Battle There Is No Law, Realm of Chaos, and War Master. I love the War Master stuff probably the most. I love just that album and hearing early material from it, which you get to do here. Let's read some tracks off. Forgotten Existence, Attack in the Aftermath, Psychological Warfare, and In Battle There Is No Law. That's the first session. The second one is Drowned in Torment, Eternal War, Realm of Chaos, and Domination. And then the third session has Destructive Infinity, War Master, Afterlife, and Lost Souls Domain. Yeah, great stuff. One thing I did notice, and this is probably a bit of a con, is that the volume levels differ not just from one album to the other, but from one disc to the other, or side to the other. So I would have liked to have had that fixed, and I don't know why they didn't, but it is what it is. All three of these titles are available at earache.com. I would buy pretty quick if you're looking for some of the more colorful vinyl variants. Oftentimes black is the one left over, which is why you saw two of the three of mine in black. But they're definitely great. You should get them. You should probably also know that Earache has peel sessions for Heresy, Intense Degree, Unseen Terror, a lot of other bands. If you're interested in those, you should check those out. I wasn't, so I didn't buy them, and hence I'm not showing them. But decent prices, too. You should check the prices on these records at earache.com. They're pretty decent for what they are. And if you have heard these sessions, what do you think about them? And maybe you have some favorite Earache bands. You should let me know that. And if you haven't heard them, would you be apt to buy them? Definitely let me know all that and anything else relevant in the comments below. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.